Hello, my wonderful spirit guides. I am back. Yes, I am. I'm not sure how many videos will be coming out, but this is a start. And I'm so glad that I'm doing this now. And I did want to do a little bit of a chat before I get started. You can skip it if you want, if this is just completely boring and you want to get into the music. But I felt like it was important for me. I had a huge breakdown. I really did. And, you know, I have complex post-traumatic stress disorder. So there are going to be triggers now and then. And when I've been overwhelmed with stress, and, you know, looking back now, I can see all the little moments leading up to the breakdown moment. And when I did break down, it was just a moment. I had to take that moment to just stop and start again. And that kind of leads to this look, which is like a phoenix from the ashes sort of thing. I mean, I don't know what's going on with the neck. It did look like something earlier, but it's kind of just gone into a weird mesh, but we'll forget about that. But yeah, this like little dark bit here was meant to kind of be like ash and stuff. And obviously these like, I don't know, feathers and yellow nose, like a beak. You know, but I thought it was quite fitting for what I've been going through. It's a rebirth and I'm emerging, and excuse this huge big jacket, like cardigan as well, just pretty chilly, but it doesn't really go with the stripes, but it's fine. Anyway, sorry, I'm acting so silly, but I'm back and I'm really happy to be back. And if you've seen my Instagram posts and my poetry, then you'll know exactly what's been going on for me. I just wanted to also break the stigma that even though I suffer with mental health like issues, I'm still, this is me, this is who I am. Like, hello, like, let's listen to some music. I'm still that person that is just like a great friend, a great mum, a great human being. Do you know what I mean? Like, people who suffer, and even if they have breakdowns, are not a mess. They're not a mess of a person. They are for a moment, but you do come back if you have that strength and willpower to keep going and divert from the alternative, which is not being here at all. It's always important that you know that, like, everything is temporary. But anyway, I know this is going to sound crazy, but I'm going to be reacting to Lingua Ignota. Ignota, again with the names, I always get them like wrong. But yes, and I understand that I've heard that Lingua like might be slightly triggering for me, or possibly, you know, just heavier subjects and so on. But I kind of want to do a bit of exposure therapy and just go for it. And maybe I'll connect to it in a way that is more healing than terrifying. Basically, what I'm trying to say is I feel ready for it. And I feel like it's important that I do this today. I've been going through my mind thinking, who should I react to? Who should I react to? Who should be the first person I react to when I come back and so on? And I was trying to think of what would be good for YouTube as well as Patreon, and there was meant to be doing this other one, but I haven't heard from the Patreon. I've asked them, oh yeah, so if you are the Patreon who requested, well, if you're a Patreon, just check your messages, because I have been asking a specific one if they still want this album request. I don't want to go forward with requests unless I fully know that they're still wanted, otherwise I've done it for nothing. And I especially didn't want to do it for nothing when I just come back to doing this, if that makes sense. But I'm going to get into it, and I'm going to be doing the album Sinners Get Ready. So let's go for it. I'm not going to be looking at lyrics. I'm basically not going to be looking at lyrics throughout the video. But in editing, if I feel it's necessary, I will like do a little bit there, maybe a voiceover, or even just write the lyrics and, you know, all that sort of thing. I find it easier just to listen, and I'm trying to change things up a slight bit, maybe pause less and talk about the song after it's done. Or if it's really important, I won't pause less, but just trying to work out ways that make me feel comfortable and here in the present and grounded, and less like I have to, less worry and anxiety a bit, basically, just being my true authentic self, but with my feet still firmly in the ground. You know what I mean? Because I get carried away. I'm a sensitive person. I get emotional and I feel things heavily, which I love about myself, but I also got to protect it. All right, let's go for it. I'm excited. Truly, I'm excited. The other thing was actually, since I've had my break and stuff, I've been finding it hard to watch, you know, videos that are about gossip or, you know, tea channels or anything negative. I used to like listening to a lot of murder mystery stuff, which is still fun, but I've had to really stay away from that this week. And I realized one of the only happier videos I do enjoy watching are reaction videos. And that made me feel really proud that this is something that I get to do, because I get to make people happy. And I just really got to notice that this week, even more so. So, yeah. So, the first song is called The Order of Spiritual Virgins. Okay. That synthy bass is so raspy, and that piano. Okay.
Hide your children, hide your husband.
I am the ocean.
Okay, so it's like a full choir. Is it the same person singing all the different parts, or are there other people involved? It reminds me slightly of Anna von Hauswolf, who I've recently reacted to. That same kind of gothic feel to it. And she was like, hide your children, hide your husband. It's like, hide your kids, hide your wife. Do you remember that meme? That whole thing that happened. It was like that viral video. I wonder if it's like, I don't know, maybe, I don't know, did she do that on purpose? But no, it sounds, yeah, I'm very interested.
So hide your children, hide your husband.
Wow. Beautiful chaos. Wow. These vocals are intense.
And all who dare look upon me swear eternal.
I love that deeper vocal. Whoa. That piano. I see kind of sparks just drifting up into the air. You know, like little firework sparks slowly drifting up into the night sky. Interests me is the bass, the synthy bass at the start, I said was quite raspy, and now listening to her vocals, they were quite full, so hide your children, they got a cry tone on them and a slightly operatic too. Hide your husband. And then here her instruments are more smooth. And yet her voice has a bit of rasp in it. It's a really nice kind of dynamic thing, like using some rasp here, some smoothness here, and switching that around with the vocal and instruments is just like kind of sonically pleasing. I don't know if it was intentional, but I do like it. Oh my god. Ah, that's spicy. I felt the blood shoot through into my hands because that shocked me so much. Oh my god, let me go back. Oh my goodness. It literally made me jump again. Wow, that's gonna mean something. It's gonna happen again, I know it. Her vocal is astonishing. Just like, it's so hard as well, the vocal. Eternal. You know, it's not, there's not much room for like, it's not very pretty in a way. It actually sounds extremely mature. You know, it sounds like a an older woman who a strict, like a, not strict, like a, firm, it's a firm kind of voice, but it's very, yeah, it has that like operatic sound that is very powerful with those, you know, I do obviously believe it's meant to have a terrifying aspect to it. It's meant to make you feel uncomfortable, scared, shocked, like the meaning is so strong. And exactly, I think the meaning is portrayed in the music very well, so I don't even have to be understanding every single word right now to know that this song is very meaningful and powerful and dark and, you know, hurt. But I think I'm definitely going to be looking into the lyrics when I edit. And then like that feedback sound. Never safe. That's it. You're never safe. Wow. This is great for October. Terrifying. I'm so scared of it just doing one last big crash. This dude. Oh, okay.
Glorious Father.
Wow. Okay, no, I have to pause it, but what the hell? That sounds good. Oh my god. That song just now was honestly terrifying, but I loved it. I don't know what I think of it yet. I love the experience of it, but I also hated it at the same time. But I think that's meant to be. I don't think it's meant to be an enjoyable, oh yeah. There's meant to be some real in it. And I wonder if the whole album is going to be that way. I also thought it was pretty cool starting the whole album with a 9-minute song, you know, pretty intense. I didn't even think of it at the time, though. I was just listening, and because it had so much progression to it. And when you have a long song with progression to it, it just feels good. It feels really good. And you don't want it to end. Oh my God, the dead silence part. You know, even him talking about the dead silence, it's like, it makes you nervous because you think, you talk about dead silence now, but there's those big crashes just now. I wouldn't call that silent, you know? So you think it's going to happen again. But slightly creepy. Is that like a, you know, is that an excerpt from something? Because I don't know. That was interesting. Very creepy. But yeah. All right then. Next song, I Who Bend the Tall Grass. Interesting. Got the organ.
Glorious Father, intercede for me. If I cannot hide from
her vocal here, inter father, it's a lot more to it than a ooh, you know. And then she's going to see from me. That's so low.
And the tall grasses bend for you.
Wow. Cannot mix all of those notes together like that. This is true horror.
Take hold of my gentle axe and split him open.
Wow.
Your golden scythe, your holy sword, your fiery arrows studded with stars.
Oh, I love it.
I don't give a fuck. Just kill him. You have to. I am not asking.
Wow. This is like theatre. This feels like true theatre. Like, I could feel her doing this, you know, on a big stage. I'm not asking. You know, she's not afraid to go there, basically. She's not afraid to go there. And if this is what she wants to really get across, that real deadly murderous anger, that absolute just rotten filthy anger, you know, that rage, and she wants to get it across that way, then yeah, she's doing a good job at it, because she's really not giving a shit about boundaries of what you know, artists should be like. She's going, this is how I want to do it. And with the organs playing, and like all her different vocal techniques are very interesting as well. But I'm loving the gravity shouting feeling. I feel it. I feel it deep, deep within me.
I have made my body your vessel. I preach your word in every room.
Wow. Wow.
And my sacrifice is not extravagant. All I have is yours, and I swear I can't do it again.
Wow.
He has to die. There is no other way.
I'm loving this. I'm feeling transported to, in her world, to her world, to her, I mean, wow, the way she goes from like a cry tone. I've been weeping, you know, and then like gets angry again and brings a crying, you know, oh, every emotion is being poured out at its greatest degree. I see, it's so weird that I've done this phoenix look, because I'm seeing so many flames listening to this. I don't know if it's all been like kind of meshed in and, you know, influenced by the fact that I was thinking of a phoenix. But in fact, I'm seeing like some real, this imagery might be a little strange to explain, but I will say it. I'm kind of seeing like a vagina. I don't know why. Come on. Right, come on. Stop it. Stop being silly. Right, I'm seeing like a vagina, and it's like, but it's got like the center of the earth in it, basically. Just like fire. The core of the earth. All the lava and fire. And it's not scary to look at. It's actually very, very powerful. I'm still trying to work out exactly what it means, but I think for me, it's just this extreme feminine energy, this feminine like pain and anger. Yeah, that's what I'm feeling. Just some real pain inside. And it's around being a female as well. And yeah, I don't know. I've heard some stuff about Lingua talk. People have told me that there's some stuff with S.A. and like R word. She sings about that in some songs. I don't know if it's on this album or the last one, but even this, you know, she's talking about like, I'm your vessel. I've preached your words in every room, and I've, you know, whipped myself with my own sorrows. It's not enough for you. There's not enough sacrifices for you. It sounds like some true hatred and pain towards someone, which I'm imagining is a man in this scenario. Maybe from the things I've already heard, and maybe just from what this is, I know that a lot of this is to do with religion. So I'm feeling a lot, and it's powerful. I'm loving this one. I'm going to carry on now, though.
It is my voice that bites the back of a cold wind, and it is I who bends the tall grasses. It is I am the one. I am the only one. I have to be.
Wow. Desperation.
I can't do it again.
She's saying I can't do it again. I'm wondering.
He belongs to me.
I'm wondering what she can't do again exactly.
If I cannot hide from you.
Wow. Neither can he. That's interesting too. Like, if I can't hide from you, neither can he. So who is the you? Is it God? Is it Satan? Is it someone else entirely? Is it a person? Is it the pain? Oh, I really do want to look into these, because I'm hearing the lyrics, but I need to understand. And I will, I definitely will. Interesting. All right, okay, so we're into many hands now. I was wondering, because that was a unique sound to end on, so I was like, that's got to be going somewhere. And it was. All right, let's go.
You better get ready.
Tiger Love album. I like that. Oh, hallelujah. Not quite that, but I liked that. It had a really, what's the word? I don't know. What is the word for that? Sort of bluesy sound.
Unforgiving night, God came.
Folky.
Plainly spoke my given name.
Oh. I really like her vocals here. Ooh.
Upon your path, for every hole you have.
Wow.
The fires that swallow the silent mountains are yours. The Lord spat and held me by my neck. I would die for you, I would die for you, he was.
Real storytelling. I could really see a fire. I could really see a fire in this, a really big bonfire, and she's telling this story while there's like men in armor, like big burly men, like sharpening their weapons, like on rocks and stuff. You know, and I could see like a old, you know, medieval campsite almost, and she's telling a story like a real, you know, this is what happened. And there's people sitting around really intently listening, and she's saying, like, did she say the orc held me by my neck? She said someone held her by her neck. And then they said, I wish it didn't have to be like this or something, or like, I can't remember now, but I'll look into it. But I thought that was interesting too. You could really see the imagery and feel the story. Again, though, I'm absolutely adoring her vocal here. Her little trills. Hey, nay. Hey, you know, I sound hilarious when I'm doing it, just like randomly segmented like that. But like, you know what I mean? Those little trills, like, oh, really good.
On your pale body, I will put many hands. Rough fingers for every hole you have.
Wow.
Yeah,
the Lord.
I wish things could be different. The Lord spat and held me by my neck. For you, I would die. For you, he
wept. Wow.
I wish things could be different. He wept.
Different. He wept. I wonder all the things that were used to create these sounds. I found it interesting that she says the Lord, no, I thought she said an orc. I was like, an orc? But she said the Lord holds me by my neck. I wish it could be different. He wept. And then, you know, I would die for you and stuff. Like, that's interesting. And I'm wondering if she means like the Lord held me by my neck, as in like the Lord had a hold on me, so I believed certain things, I didn't do lots of things, I had to stick by these religious rules, I couldn't breathe, I didn't have a voice, I didn't have a choice, you know, I had to just follow the Lord's way. And I wonder if it's something to do with that. I guess I'll find out. Anyway, next song is called Pennsylvania, not surface, Pennsylvania Furnace.
Me and the dog, we die together.
Jazzy. Really showing off her vocals there.
I know you want to stop, but you can't stop.
I like that reverb on stop then. It just went, it transcended into the... I love this one. Sorry, I feel like I'm not saying a lot, but I'm just digesting.
Where you live with your family. Is everything
burned? The way that went. Rumbling drum. Oh!
I feel your voice.
Oh my gosh!
Above all others. Me and the dog, we die.
Wow.
Together.
Wow. Gosh, so who is that about then? All this curiosity. I'm like, oh, what's that about? Like, me and the dog. We die above all others. And interestingly, dog backwards is God. And I don't know whether she's saying, like, I hear your voice only about God. But this, I like that one a lot. I really felt that one. Like, it really touched me. And I felt I was moving with it. Oh, that was beautiful. Like, just... every little part, and then when that drum hit came in, dum, and then the rising of like a, you know, it'd feel like you're going up, 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 and then fall into a very sad sort of somber sound, and it would repeat that in different ways. Gorgeous. All right, next song, Repent Now, Confess Now. Oof. Really loves using those like horror sounds, very atonal sounds, notes that, you know, aren't pretty together. Ooh, that low vocal though. Now. Ooh. Ooh. So jaunty. I think it might go into the other one, but I am actually going to pause it. Yeah, did I even pause in that song? I don't think I did. There was moments where I was like, I don't know about this one. I don't know. And it's not that, oh, I don't like it or I love it. It was, I don't know. Like, I literally don't know. I need time with that one. Because I love the jaunty boom. You know, at first it made me think of like a sort of a dance that you do with a lover, you know, like a very like a medieval dance that you do in like at a ball, but it was a little bit like a horror version of that. So instead of being like blum, 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 it had like that real jaunty dark sound to it, and I found that really intriguing. Then all the vocals came in, and I'm not sure what it was, but I feel like all the vocals in this one, I was trying to latch on to like one vocal more than another at some points or whatever. I don't know. It just wasn't my favourite part until it later in the song where it kind of like, oh no, when she did her own vocal just on her own. And then it went into, you know, it got bigger, and then all the sounds and the vocals all made sense again. I don't know, it just sounded, I really liked the end the most, and the slower bit of her vocal, just the one vocal. But lyrics intriguing again. I think when I look more into that, I will be like, oh, very cool. But you know, he took my legs, you know, that's interesting. What's that meant to mean? Is it, you know, is it a metaphoric in a sense of like he took my ability to leave, to go anywhere, to like be able to get away from something? That was an interesting one. Not my favourite, but I still just, I don't know, you know? Yeah. Anyway, okay. Next one is called The Sacred The Sacred Lineament of Judgment. Lineament? I don't know. Let's go for it. Oh, I love the distressed strings on the last one as well.
My wounds that stung before now sing. My soul has been bedecked with jewels.
The distressed sound on those strings, like brr, brr, that's how it sounds. It sounded like, I don't know if it is, but it sounds like someone screaming in the background, like ah, ah, you know, like real, like distressed, like screaming in the background. That's interesting.
With Sunday.
In that little moment, her vocal sounded like a well played bagpipe. You know, she had all the layers and a hey, and then like the hey, all the different sounds it did, and the underlying that raspy synth again. It did, and that folky kind of melody to it too had a bit of a bagpipe sound to it. Just did. That synth sounds like a bagpipe too.
Shall I stand on that great day?
I want to address myself
in bright celestial robes arrayed with cool fingers
mine. Let us hold the standard of righteousness. It's evangelism. Are heralds and cryos of redemption. It's mission.
I'm gonna have to say again, this one I'm actually kind of leaning more into, I don't know if I like this one yet. Like the one before was like, I don't know. I feel like I liked it a lot more than this one though. This one, I don't know. It's moving in a way that's, I'm zoning out just a little bit. The male voice talking and the vocal together, I can't concentrate on one or one or the other. The music is very much dominating this one. I do like that. It's just very like, you know, sound. It sounds like a, you know, like a buckles on a horse, like the foot bits, the foot places, placement parts. I don't know what they're called, but I don't know. Can I do, eh? I gotta be honest. But yeah, I imagine the lyrics are pretty deep, but I'm not getting it because there's a bit too much going on, I think.
Wow.
I wish I could hear him just a little bit more. Is he saying I have sinned? Interesting. I feel like it's probably got a lot of meaning. It might follow the story of the album. It doesn't hit me sonically, unfortunately. Okay, so this song is Perpetual Flame of Centralia. I'm also going to sit down for a minute because my back is starting to hurt quite a lot. Yeah, my back was starting to hurt quite a bit. So, and usually in my videos, I just power through it. But I'm, you know, with everything that's been going on, I've been trying to do things differently. And I'm you know, trying to tell myself, sit down or stand up or do whatever you want, because, you know, of my chronic pain and so on, I have to do what's right and stop trying to power through it because it won't help. But anyway, that's why I'm sat down. But yeah, that one, I don't know yet. I don't know. It didn't give me a feeling, much feeling, compared to the other ones, you know? But anyway, there's only two songs left, actually. Okay, let's do it. Man is like a spring flower. Oh, no, no. It's perpetual flame of... So three songs. So three songs. Perpetual flame of Centralia.
I am covered with the blood of Jesus.
I love how she sings that so, like, beautifully, actually. I really like her voice like this.
When the path is rough. My head.
Wow. Ooh, gives me shivers.
In a holy kingdom.
I love this already. So many goosebumps.
Life is a song.
I love how she's singing so held back. And the fires of hell burn on and on. A bit like I was saying in the Anna von Halswolf. It's, you know, they have, both of these ladies have extremely powerful voices. But they also have great control. And like the on and on. It's all very much like, you know, when you're brushing your teeth and you go with an electric toothbrush, it's like, but yeah, because it's all very much inside the mouth rather than outside of it. But I love that kind of control, and I like that feeling of like knowing someone's controlling their vocal in a certain way because you know the potential it has to go wild. There's something to it.
In the raging fires of hell.
Oh. Beautiful. Oh, I love this. I feel like I already know the words to this one. Pause it. I don't want to pause this.
Life is a song.
Life is a song. that's the end. Oh, I could have listened to that forever. Anything I can get singing to, I love. Truly, when I start singing along, you know I'm into it. You know I am.
Crying, and I know those tears aren't real.
How do you know?
This can't be. I mean, because he was up there preaching about all this stuff and then doing it, you know, and...
But couldn't his tears of repentance be real?
That's the real person, I think he was.
Ooh, who's that about? Anyway, the song is called Man is Like a Spring Flower. But, oh, that's interesting. All these little references and, like, quotes and stuff, you know. I'm like, ooh, yeah, it does interest me. Okay, yes, Man is Like a Spring Flower. Sorry, getting carried away. Man is like a spring flower. Okay. Well, an orchid is it to do with death? Orchids?
The heart of man is the open conscious self. The heart of man is a furnace.
Not quite a spring flower then.
The heart of man is the burning barn.
Oh, I liked that. Orchid! The harmony.
The heart of man is the seventh gate of hell. The heart of man is the crushed horse's tail.
Poor horsey. Okay, interestingly, I had to peek round because I was like, is this going to be a short song that just does that, what it was doing, or will it be a long song that changes? I was just curious, so I looked, and I was like, well, it's 7 minutes long, so if it does just that for 7 minutes, I'm not sure if I'm going to love it, because I'm loving it right now, but maybe not for 7 minutes. But it's changing up, and I'm like, oh, bring on the 7 minute song, I'm up for that. Wow. Powerful. Epic, actually. Wow. Giving me shivers. This all feels like it's leading somewhere. Oh, little bits added. Just keeps adding to it. Oh, I love her low vocal. It's so nice when it's pulled back. You know, it's like da-da-da-da-da-da, and it's really getting there, which is, like, amazing. I love that. I've got a hair in my eye. I mean, I got a feather in my eye. Okay. But I love how it's, like, all held back. Building, and then when she wants to sing low on its own, the music drops out a little bit and you can hear that low register come through. I think it's beautiful. This is that is... Oh, I was about to say, you know, when a song has like a certain to it, like that one had like a, but when it has that very choppy sound, it always feels like you're progressing forward. It just always does. Doesn't matter what song it is, like you're just always moving forward. That's what that sound gives. And that song certainly had that. Just constant moving forward. And it doesn't necessarily mean up or down. It's just one way. And I was wondering, like, how will this end? You know, where, how does it stop? And the way it stopped was by, you know, just amping up the volume and having it break under the compression. And just, it kind of abruptly stopped the way it does, you know, end. You know, we're like, you know, it really just put a stop in the journey. Whew, another really good one. That didn't feel like 7 minutes, if I'm honest. That literally, well, I didn't feel like it had any time to it, but I would say it felt like 3 minutes to me. I don't know why or how. I just feel like I melted inside of it. I was just following it. Oof, okay, I can't wait to hear all these songs again. And like, I don't know, how do you wrap your head around them? They're so unique. It's definitely not like anything I've heard before. Definitely, there's nothing I've heard like this. The Anna von Halswolf had similarities, definitely. But other than, you know, Anna, who I hadn't heard of before as well, this, I'm like, there's really nothing I could compare it to apart from, you know, a gothic medieval sort of sound. Okay, it's the last song now, and it's called The Solitary Brethren of Ephrata. Let's do it!
You're concerned you could infect other people if you get sick inside.
No.
People who don't go to this church.
No, I'm covered in Jesus' blood. I'm covered in Jesus' blood.
But what about other people who don't go to this church who you might encounter?
All of these people go to this church.
No, but you're going to be in places where other people
I go
are.
To the grocery store every day. I'm in Walmart, what? Home Depot, all of those
people.
But you
could get them sick from what happens.
They
the
could
church.
Get me sick, but they're not because I'm covered in his blood. Thank you very much.
When did this come out? Okay. Yep. It sounds like they're talking about COVID, doesn't it? Am I allowed to say that in videos at the moment? Apparently you're not allowed to say that. But it sounds like the old pandemic we've been going through. And that sounded like a religious Karen, if I'm honest. So let's see how this goes.
Thank you very much.
I like that sound. Oh, beautiful. Slightly French. Gorgeous. Find it interesting that that low register that I enjoy is very much the dominant in this one. It feels like a lot more of like a sacred sort of sound, a sound to herself, you know. I can't tell what she's saying very much, but like, paradise will be mine. I feel like this song has a like positive feeling to it. I love that. That's beautiful. Oh. Wow. Sounds like a very deep Christmas song. I didn't find it as beautiful as, yeah, Perpetual Flame of Centralia, I think might actually have to be my favourite. I just want to go through the song list. Also, this was great. I fucking did it. I did it. My first video back, I did it. And it feels good. I felt good. I felt very calm. Okay, the Order of Spiritual Virgins was terrifying. Like, quite terrifying, yes. It was beautiful. It was an interesting introduction because I was like, ooh, like, I didn't know what it was going to be like at all. But the vocals, all of it. But that the big, like, dum, 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 you know, like the big scary sounds. God, they made me jump every time. I Who Bend the Tall Grasses, I loved that one, actually. That's got to be on my favourites, I think, because I absolutely loved the, like anger in her voice, and then like, the, like, crying. It was very theatrical. Many Hands. What was this one? Oh, yeah, I loved Many Hands as well, because that one had, like, a very, like, what was I saying, like a medieval sort of camping ground and telling a story, and like the Lord holds her by her neck. Her vocals were quite phenomenal in that one. I really enjoyed that. Okay, then the next one was Pennsylvania Furnace. I really enjoyed that one too. That one had like a jazzy feeling. It was the first sort of stripped back sort of sound we'd heard. So I really enjoyed it. I really enjoyed the vocals in that. Repent Now, Confess Now. I think that one I was a bit, that was one I didn't know about, isn't it? I think I actually quite like it now when I think of some of the ones that I didn't love. But I think that one's okay, especially towards the end. I really quite enjoyed it. The Sacred Lineament of Judgment. I think that one was the one that I was a bit like, I just didn't really feel it, unfortunately. Perpetual Flame of Centralia, absolutely stunning, that one is. Really, really, really love that. Everything about it, perfect. Man Is Like a Spring Flower, I really enjoyed the start, and I liked how it went into that movement, dun-dun-dun-dun feeling. I felt like there could have been something more, but maybe that's just me being choosy. And then the last one, The Solitary Brethren of Ephrata. I liked it. I didn't love it, I have to admit. But I did like it. It was just okay, yeah. So a bit of a mixed bag on this one, but the ones I really liked, I really liked. So I would definitely be interested to hear more from Lingua. She's got me curious as to what her other songs sound like, whether they are, you know, different or all in the same sort of sound. I don't know. I'm very interested. But yeah, I'm going to be doing some looking into her before I, you know, get this video up and stuff. And yeah, hopefully it'll be a good video where I can actually add some knowledge in there, you know. But yeah, it's just easier for me to do the lyrics afterwards if I feel like it sort of thing, rather than right there and then, because that gets quite stressful and tiring. Anyway, however, that was an extremely interesting album. I'm actually really glad that was the album that I came back to, because if it was something that was too high energy, I'd be a little bit worried about Well, actually, saying that, the energy was high, but you know what I mean? Not like a high pop energy. I might not have been able to connect quite as well. But this one, I felt like it actually, I could feel it quite deep within. The emotions are so obvious, you know, that you can't really be blind to them, which was important for me right now because I need that. I really need that. I need that, like, obviousness, which is pretty amazing. But anyway, I really hope you enjoyed this video, and yeah, join me on Patreon if you'd like to. You know, if you just like, if there's any spots in the album tier and you only ever want that one album, you know, you can just pay once and then leave and I'll email you the video. I've got an album request for Perfume Genius coming, and because I did a Wheel of Fortune for the middle tier, so that will be coming, and live streams, song request live streams. I have been including the £3 tiers just for the first couple times because just getting used to it and so on. Yeah. Anyway, yeah, so bye. See ya.